In this video, we will make the best lens caps with magnets. I bet you that you have lost one of your caps, or you know someone that lost at least one lens cap. Because many times you are in a hurry and it can go out of your hoodie or shirt pocket, or you miss your jean pocket, and if you are on grass or sand, it won't make any sound and your cap will be forgotten forever. I even once found a cap on a trekking road years ago. These caps join the power of magnets and by color 3D printing, using only 4 magnets, 3 for the holder and 1 for the cap. This mechanism attracts a pin that locks the cap in the holder, as you can see in this animation in Fusion 360, and only can be released using a small lever to remove the lock pin. First, we'll need to print the magnetic holder. For this, you can use a 0.2mm layer height and wait for the printing to finish. This is a printing place design, so you won't need support or assembly the holder. Once finished, just place 3 8mm by 3mm neodymium magnets inside the cap holder and glue them using any kind of glue. You can find these magnets easily on any online stores. The orientation of the magnets is not important for now. Now, let's create our awesome lens caps. I used 2 colors of filament to make these caps with a nice built-in logo. For this, you can follow the next step. First, we will add the name or design of our cap. In the past video, I taught how to make this using Tinkercad, and you can watch this video in my channel. But now I will do it using Fusion 360. Open the STL file inside Fusion 360 by clicking in Insert Mesh, select the model from your computer, and click OK. Go to the Mesh tab and click on Modify and Convert Mesh Tool. Select the model and click on OK. As you notice, the model is made by Smile Triangles. Select a triangle of the front face and press Delete. Now the front face is just one piece. Select the front face of the cap, go to the Solid tab and select Create New Sketch. Now we will use the text tool to create the name of the lens. Click on Create and Text. Click on the area you will insert the text, so we can insert the name and the font. Select the height that covers the area you want. You can use more than one text, or you can create your own logo using insert SVG file. Once done with the name or the design you want, click on Finish Sketch and extrude the design into the body. Press E for extrude or select the extrude tool. Select the text or design and insert -0.6mm. Click on OK and your design is now engraved into the body of the cap. Now we can export the design back to an STL file and print it. Right click on the body and select Save as Mesh. Click on OK and it's done. To make this print a bicolor print, follow these steps. I will use Cura as a slicer software, but you can find the equivalent process to apply a multicolor print in your favorite slicer. First, load the model. You can use a larger height of 0.2mm as maximum to keep the resolution of the cap trips and the separation of the tabs and the main body. Click on Slice and View Preview, so we can find the layer where the letters or the sign starts. In my case, it's layer number 4. Now go to Extensions, Post Processing and Modify G-Code. Here we will add a script and click on Filament Change and enter the layer where the letter or design starts, 4. Then add another filament change 3 or 5 layers above the last one, slice again, copy the file to your SD card and it's ready to print. Start the printing process with a dark color filament. Once the printer reaches the 4th layer, the print will pause and wait for you to change the filament. Remove the dark color filament and place the bright color filament. Press the button on the printer and will start to heat the hot end again. Once heated, you can resume the print or extrude the filament. Press extrude first to remove the residue of the last filament. Remove the extruded filament and press resume print. The printer now will print the 3 or 5 layers of the bright color. Once done, repeat the same process to insert back the dark color filament and wait for the best magnetic lens cap. Once done, you can place the magnet. For this, put the cap in the holder first. This will help us to place the right orientation of the magnet. You can use any kind of glue to keep the magnet in place. Just remember not to apply heat because magnets lose their properties with heat. Once the glue is dry, insert one of the arms of the binder clip that will work as a spring. And you are done. An amazing custom cap that should be a standard for any camera company. And if you know someone from Sony, Canon, Nikon, Fuji or Lumix, share them this video. Let's try to make this a standard. It just feels great to have a magnetic cap holder on your strap or your back shoulder pad. And because of magnets, you can feel like storing your Captain America shield. And it's even a great fidget story when you're bored. Thanks for watching, and please consider to like and share this video, that will help me a lot. And consider to support me on my Buy Me a Coffee page. All the files you will need are in the description below. And if we cannot make them cheaper, we will make them better.